Ready? These are those glued sounds. Put your hand on your throat, like on your voice box. Eng. Eng. Like in sang.
At Woodlawn Elementary, we use the walk to read or walk to intervention model. And the model we're using, grade level teams group students based on their strengths and needs. In third grade at Woodlawn, we use a rotation format where small groups rotate to three different teachers and complete different phonemic awareness, decoding, encoding, and comprehension activities that reinforce the phonics pattern introduced to the group that day. The kids will start with Ms. Harrison, who was one of our reading interventionists. She's really focused on the phonics, the decoding of the words.
Do you see an FF, an SS, or LL after the vowel?
LL.
Okay, when we see those glossy sounds, what do? We draw a what under? A smile to show that they make one sound.
So we're gonna read a story about Mr. Gold.
We're reading for comprehension when they come to me. So I begin by looking at what we call the graphemes and phonemes of the word. I'll introduce a new word to them. For example, today's word was bounce. So we talked about which letters make which sounds in the word bounce. And I really focused on that OU digraph of vowels so we can get the ow sound. I then introduced the poem about a cat. So the students then focused on finding those letters in the poem that had the same phonemes that we were talking about, like they're gonna look for that OU sound. When you go to your next team, next rotation, I want you to look for words that rhyme with mind. And then when they get to Miss Gill, they're gonna be working on encoding words.
Mine, sign, house, mouse. So what was Mr. Dunleavy's direction to you? What kind of rhyming words are we looking for in this text? What are we looking for?
Mind.
So we're looking for words that rhyme with mind. Everybody say it. Mind.
3 years ago, we started following the science of reading. We measure success of our program mostly through the iReady test.
Do one last word.
We also look at the students' reading fluency using our passage reading fluency assessments and their encoding skills using our spelling test, the DSA. We progress monitor students as they move through skills and use time in our language arts CT meetings to discuss progress based on the data.
Raise your hand if you can tell me, what did I do wrong?
I have seen a trend in my students when they come to me. Now, after 3 years of phonics instruction, they're coming in with phonemes and phonics at a higher level. I also see my students progressing at a much faster rate. My students were able to pass the SOL at a much higher rate than they had previously, which, considering that more than half of my students are English as a second language learners, is pretty amazing.